My next cardiac event came around 3 years after the overdose-related episodes on March 17, 2014, a week before Regent's death. I passed out when the doctor was with me. When I came to, I could not figure out what the commotion was about. Then they asked me to get into a wheelchair. As they wheeled me, my left side became weak and I felt like I could sleep forever, and everything would be okay. But after I lay in the bed, I soon improved, and drank tea. I noticed. They put up a board by my bed, I was a heart attack or stroke risk, but they took the notice away and lied they had never put one there. Later when I tried to access my record of that hospitalization, the record claimed I was admitted for a sprained ankle. A sprained ankle is probably not a sufficient reason to admit someone to a hospital. I feel that since they tell lies, their care would be unreliable. At least those who are lied to about their medical conditions must be at risk if they get treatment at that hospital, or from being under the care of a doctor who lies about the patient's medical condition. Illnesses and other acts of God would not be the only factors that would place my life at risk in such a hospital. Why do I have such a negative attitude? I did not say I am definitely at risk inside that hospital. I am sure I was at risk there at some point. I also feel sure if they lie, they have a motive. I am not psychic and cannot foretell that something bad or intentionally fatal is going to be done to me in a hospital that lies and lies. I would hope for the best if I found myself inside such a hospital. I would not worry unduly. I would know something is wrong with my care. Vertigo started to come in spurts in 2014. This was entirely new. It stopped after a few months. In October or November 2015, I started to feel very tired when I was walking about in Brighton. This was entirely new. I decided it was my heart and my life force was decreasing. I went back to my boyfriend's home. That was when I had my first really bad cardiac episode since the two episodes in January and February 2011. It was January 18, 2016. My boyfriend took me to Ealing Hospital. My chest pain and breathing difficulties got so bad that I felt that I should die or I get medical intervention relief somehow. The doctors eventually saw me and they put me on a saline drip for a few hours and then I went home with my boyfriend. Their diagnosis was non-cardiac chest pain. They did a blood test for troponin. The ECG on that occasion showed some abnormalities. I think I have those ECGs. A lot of people go to accident and emergency with chest pains. Most of them come out with a diagnosis of non-cardiac chest pain. Actually, the truth is the doctor does not know if the chest pain is non-cardiac, but says so to make patients go away soon. People who have never experienced heart problems would panic if a doctor tells them the truth, which is he does not know if it is your heart. When someone goes to accident and emergency with chest pains, the doctor does an ECG, which will flag up an ongoing heart attack but is not accurate. You could have heart disease and could have had a heart disease in the past or in the future while showing a normal ECG. The other thing the doctor does when you go to accident and emergency with chest pains is a blood test. They check your troponin levels in your blood test. Troponin rises after a heart attack. It stays high for a few hours or a day. The test will show nothing if you had a heart attack a week ago or have had several in your life. You can also leave an accident and emergency with a normal ECG and die of heart problems later that day. In other words, if any person goes to accident and emergency with chest pains for the very first time, they are likely to undergo an ECG and a blood test, followed by a diagnosis of normalcy, and to told to leave. Both tests are unreliable. In my particular case, doctors went on lying that my ECG was normal, when it was not normal. This lie may be the standard way of dealing with someone who comes to accident and emergency for the first time with chest pains. But this lie needs to fall apart. By the time that person has been to accident and emergency umpteen times with chest pain, with other telltale symptoms and abnormalities in the ECG, you don't need high school education to know that without fire, there is no smoke. Look, I won't bother telling a UK or Ireland person what to believe when there are contradictions. Your ECG graph says you are abnormal, but the doctor interpreting it says it is normal. You can go ahead and believe the doctor, but I will believe the machine. You argue that you cannot understand the works written by the machine on your ECG graph, only a doctor can interpret them. Fine. There are hundreds of different words written on the ECG graphs by the machine. The doctor tells you all these hundreds of words mean the same word, normal. You won't Google those words to see what they mean, since you are too illiterate to understand them. You do what you want, baby. You are treated like someone who needs to be spat on and shat on, since nobody will speak to you. On the whole, you lead a contented life, as this does not bother your earthy conscience. You lack adult reflexes that's supposed to creep onto you as a natural part of reaching maturation. You are a naked ape that stares at people like an Alsatian dog or fuzzy Malamute. I think this is a deficiency that arises from growing up under a man-made sky. Never ever have you been able to look up and see the light that comes down from the heavens. As a substitute for human dignity, you are commercially supplied with woman-to-woman commercial intimacy by women hailing from socially backward groups. These women are called advisors, agency workers, and women supporting women, listening services, psychological services, and mental health services, painkiller substitutes, just radiating warmth. Women need women as a human rights services. These women become your spokesperson and bridge to the authorities, women's window to the world, a seeing eye dog to women, professional mentor. Filled with comfort and praise, face starers, lax and loose, sleeping like babies from 9 to 7, like the bread that came down from heaven, with 90 degrees between their parted legs. These women are experts at bego pleto. These women will give you approval and acceptance if you trust and obey doctors. I am detained indefinitely under the woman restriction, so I either become a drop in the woman slurry or pass away. I feel some men of the bureaucracy wish me dead for the greater good, because I don't liaise with women who are a thing of pleasure and powerful growth forever and ever. That is by the way. You walk the road you want to walk, baby. We cannot become a pair, but if you want to blindly trust doctors and everyone else, it will help you. The system is built to reward its mental dependence, its moral dependence. It is likely, although not certain, that you will be safe if you blindly trust doctors when they lie to you. You will be safer than me on the whole. This way of lying to me that the tests came out normal when they didn't, is persisting into the present date of August 2023, long after I have been formally diagnosed with diastolic dysfunction, a type of heart failure.